David Camm's team wrapped up the first week of his defense by trying to prove the blood evidence supports their version of events. Today's focus, again, was on whether tiny drops of blood on Camm's shirt put him at the scene when his family was murdered. Marissa Alter is live outside the Boone County Courthouse with the latest. Marissa?
Vicki, that testimony again came today from forensic expert Barry Goetz, who spent a second day on the stand, this time being grilled by the prosecution. The state has built its case around the fact that blood, or rather the opinion, that blood on Camm's shirt is spatter. But Goetz has a different explanation.
I mean, I've always had hope. I've always believed, ultimately, that the truth would prevail. You find strength in that.
That's David Camm in an exclusive interview with WLKY leading up to his third trial for the murders of his wife Kim and kids Brad and Jill. After 17 days of state witnesses, it's now his team's turn to present evidence. The defense has a handful of experts who will take the stand over the next few weeks. Barry Goetz is the first to offer an alternative to the prosecution's theory that dots of Jill's blood on Camm's shirt mean he was within 4 feet when she took a bullet.
That's the evidence to me. Again, I know they're going to make it a little cloudy, but let them do what they can do.
And Goetz did that, telling the jury the blood doesn't show Camm was in his Georgetown home's garage when his family was shot. He said it's clearly transfer and supports Camm's version of what he did that night. Goetz even showed a video of a reenactor reaching over Jill in the Bronco to pull Brad out and perform CPR. In the clip, his shirt brushes against Jill's hair, which Goetz says produces a bloodstain pattern like the one Camm had. But on cross, Special Prosecutor Stan Levko laid into Goetz about the accuracy of the reenactment. He pointed out it was missing Jill's backpack, which had been on the Bronco's seat next to her that night. Goetz admitted that leaving it out was a mistake and might affect the reenactment's validity. Levko also attacked him for only doing the experiment with Jill in one position when it's possible she could have been in another. Jurors heard more than 11 hours of testimony from Goetz over 2 days, a fraction of what they'll have to digest from different experts by the time the trial ends.
I think this is a really intelligent jury. So, you know, ultimately, I think they'll be able to understand the evidence. So I'm really not concerned they're going to be overwhelmed.
The only thing I can tell from the jurors' questions is that they are paying attention. They are listening, and they have good questions.
And to date, the jury has asked 169 questions, many of them multi-part. Court resumes here Tuesday morning. Reporting in Lebanon, I'm Marissa Alter, WLKY News.